Everyone, this is Amit. Welcome to another Notepad++ tip. In this video, we will learn how we can connect to FTP server right from Notepad++. Now, you might be using FileZilla or WinSCP or any other FTP client to access your data from your web server, but Notepad++ makes it much easier to do this, and you don't need to leave Notepad++. And so let's get started. We need to install a plugin called NPPFTP. And so let's go ahead and go to plugins and go to plugin admins. And you need to search for FTP. And usually it shows up right here, NPPFTP. And if you want to learn more about this particular plugin, you can actually go to their GitHub page and learn more about it. But as it says, it allows FTP and SFTP and other communication as well. And so I'm going to install that. In order to install, you need to click this button and just click install, and it'll ask you to restart your Notepad++. So I'm going to say yes. And once it's done, you should be able to install this plugin. Now, you can see that in under plugins, and right here it says NPPFTP. And if you click on the show NPPFTP window, now you have this sidebar where you can create new profile for your FTP server, and you can connect and access different files. So in order to test this plugin and just trying to connect to FTP server, we are going to use a test FTP server that is out there. You can go to this website and see that they provide an easy read-only FTP access to a server. And so we are going to create a new profile. And so in order to create a new profile, you need to go to this setting window and go to profile settings. Sorry, it's a little cut out, but it says profile settings. And I'm going to just create a new profile. So I'll just call it Rebex. That's the name of the... I just searched online for a free test FTP server. So this is called test.rebex.net. Now for your test, you can use your own. I'm just using just a test server. And then the username is demo, and the password is password. And once I did that, if I close it, it'll save these profile, right? And so I'm going to click close. And now I have created this profile. So if I would like to connect to this FTP server and access some of the files there, all you have to do is you have to go here. And then it'll show all your profiles. So I would like to connect to this. So click on that. And soon you can see that it is able to connect to this FTP server, and it is showing me the file that I can download. And so if I double click on one of these files, it should be able to open right in Notepad++. You can see it just downloaded. I can make this a little bigger so that you can see it. And then now I am able to edit this particular file. In your case, it can be any other file that you are trying to edit. Now, because this isn't just a read-only server, we won't be able to upload our changes. But for that, there is another website which provides this free, just a quick FTP test. And so we'll try that. So right here, you can see it's dlptest.com, and they have a username and password. And usually you can upload the file and it'll stay there for about 30 minutes. And so let's try that. And I'm going to create another profile. But this time we'll call this DLP test. All right, so I just created a DLP test profile using the hostname, username, and password that this particular site gave me. And the file that you upload will be stored only for 30 minutes. So this is only for testing purposes. But I got all these information. I'm going to click close. And as usual, in order to connect, I need to go to this icon, click on that and let's try DLP test. So it'll take just a fraction of a second to connect, and now you can see I am connected to this FTP server. Now let's go ahead and try to upload one, just a test file. So let's say this is the test file that I'm working on, and I would like to upload this on this particular FTP. So there are different icons right here. One of these says upload file, and so I can make the changes and I can click on that, and it's trying to upload it. And there you go, it is able to upload this README file on the server right from Notepad++. And so that's what we learned today. We can easily connect to any FTP server right from Notepad++, and we can download, make changes, and upload it back without leaving Notepad++. So I hope you guys like this tip. If you like that, please click that like button, and also please subscribe to my channel to get more videos like that. All right, thank you very much.